Welcome to more Pokemon Stadium 2! Today we're finally gonna go, and as you can see right here, insert our Pokemon Crystal cartridge and go and use our team in 3D in Pokemon Stadium 2 here. So we're gonna go into the stadium, and the only place our Pokemon can really play is the Poke Cup. As you can see, it's level 50 through 55. That fits the description of my team. Now we've got the four difficulties here. I think that I'll use the team for the Pokeball and then the Master Ball. I think it might be a little bit boring if I just use the same team the whole way through, but I definitely want to just go ahead and use them right away instead of waiting, and then we'll wait to use them with the Master Ball afterwards as well. So we'll do Pokeball and Master Ball with the team here. So when we have the cartridge inserted, we can just go ahead and select that, and it'll show us our Pokemon right here. As you can see, we've got all these guys. Now we've also got stuff in the box, but for some reason we can only see box 2. I don't know why. Oh, I bet you it's because that's the only box that contains another Pokemon that's level 50. So Snorlax is our only other level 50 here. But alright, we're just gonna go ahead and choose everyone. The order we choose them in doesn't really matter, so we'll just go ahead and spam them all on here. Now, eventually I will tweak the movesets a little bit, especially for Arthur, but for now, it's fine. Their movesets are pretty good, and the battles in the Poke Cup are not going to be that crazy. I raised my bug Pokemon carefully. They'll take you on. All right then, dude. And as you can see, a bunch of pretty weak bug Pokemon. This might be a bit of a stomp, so we're going to go ahead and, of course, start with Vesta. We'll go ahead and put Tuix in there as well. And why not? We'll put our own Nox. I don't know, man. It doesn't really matter. Our own bug Pokemon, I mean to say. So let's go ahead and get into our first round of the Poke Cup. Now, the Challenge Cup, that's pretty challenging. Even the Little Cup, pretty gosh dang challenging. The Poke Cup will be challenging a little bit later on, but not so much in the Pokeball to start here. To start, it's pretty simple. At this point, you pretty much just choose good Pokemon and you win. Now, once you get to Master Ball later on, stuff can be really challenging. It's a lot easier when you have a custom-built team from the actual game, because then you can have stuff above level 50. If you choose the rental Pokemon, they're always only level 50. You have to deal with the exact movesets they give you. So bringing your own Pokemon, getting to change their movesets and all that stuff can definitely help out a lot. But later on, it really will get more challenging for sure. So here we've got a Spinarak, so we're basically just gonna flamethrower a few times and win. There's not a whole lot to this one. So yeah, Vesta's probably gonna sweep this one. I don't think there's anything they could send out against me that would probably even get a chance to hurt me at all. Unless they maybe know, like, Quick Attack or something. That would probably be the only thing that could save them. And the final Pokemon is Venonat, which is gonna be very easy to defeat. We're gonna flamethrower that one just like we did the first two. And wow, dude, Venonat's like bigger than Houndoom. It's so weird. That's one thing that I love about seeing the Pokemon in Pokemon Stadium, is you really get to see just like how big and small they really are. Because when you imagine Venonat, you probably imagine him pretty small, but he's actually really big. I mean, they give you like the height and stuff in the Pokedex, but it doesn't really hit home until you really see it in 3D. Especially like with Natu, for example. We won't get to see it with Tuix here because there's Zatu, but the unevolved form Natu is so small, it's ridiculous. But alright, Bugcatcher Nelson, defeated! I guess these things happen. Yep. And then we get the Zephyr Badge. And let's continue. I think we're gonna get lots of good continues here, no problem. Let's see what we have next. Battle 2 is gonna be a Swimmer, so it's probably going to be time for Rita, maybe some Poo as well. When I watch to see my troubles get washed away, a battle, okay. And yep, well, at least he has a Poliwhirl. I mean, at least he's got an evolved Pokemon. But yeah, we're gonna use Rita up front, obviously, our grass type. Now, Poo also has Thunder Punch, so we'll bring him along. And it doesn't really matter who else we bring. I guess we'll bring Tuix again. Why not? And there we go, we've got Rita! The colors look a little bit different, and that's because, again, the nicknames. I mentioned this in a previous episode, but the nicknames can kind of change the color palettes of your Pokemon. So if my Pokemon looks slightly off, that's because they're nicknames. Let's go for Razor Leaf here. I don't know if it'll be faster. Okay, we will be! I'm guessing that Rita's probably going to sweep this team just like Houndoom swept the last one. They start off with Poliwhirl, probably their strongest Pokemon, and he gets one shot. So if he's getting one shot, then everything else probably will as well. Let's go check out what his second Pokemon is going to be here. Fighting gosh dang Bruce the Swimmer. His second Pokemon is going to be a Staryu. What the crud is this guy's name? Yumer? How does he even get that? How do you... Okay, I guess Yu's probably from Staryu, and then he sticks Mur onto it for some reason. I don't know, man. I think he had that with Poliwhirl as well. I think he had Whirlmur, so I guess this guy's gimmick is he takes the last syllable of the name and then adds Mur to it. It's kind of bizarre, but we'll see what his final Pokemon is here. And that is going to be a Goldeen. Okay, so this time he took the first syllable, so it's Goldeemur instead of I guess Deanmer. I don't know, man. Really, really weird names on this guy, but one more Razor Leaf, and down will go them as well. Critical hit, down goes Goldeen! Hooray! Look at my trainer, dude. I'm actually a girl because my character in Pokemon Crystal's a girl, I'm guessing. So there we got the Hive Badge. Two badges to go. Well, I don't know, man. I'll see how long the episode is by the time we get to the fourth battle. If it's under 10 minutes because we're just swamping this crud, I might go ahead and finish the entire cup because, yeah, this is a little bit of destruction here. The mountains are the greatest. It's inspiring to see a sunrise from the summit. Okay, we're up against Chester here, and he's got some fighting stuff, but mostly rock Pokemon here. All right, I guess we're going to start off with... let's start off with Arthur. We'll also bring Tuix, and we'll bring Rita. Let's go. All right, Arthur coming out. Look at this guy. He's such a delightful shade of light blue there. And he's going to send out a Graveler. All right. What? His name is High Gravel. I'm guessing the high is from, like, Hiker or something. We'll go for Surf here. I mean, Hydro Pump is technically stronger, but a lot less accurate. And honestly, I just want to hit them with whatever we can. Now, notice this Graveler's level is 51. If you choose Rental Pokemon, you will always be level 50, but your opponents will not always be level 50. There will be cases where you, like this, find a level 51, and this is still Pokeball, so it gets even more challenging as you get higher levels and stuff, as you get to, like, Master Ball and all that. And some Pokemon will be up to level 55. Now, keep in mind, they are stuck with the same rules as you are, so if they do have a level 55, that means their other two Pokemon are 50. The combination has to be 155 or less, and that's why my Pokemon are level 51 and 52, because 52 plus 52 plus 51 is 155, so with the current setup of Pokemon I have, I can always bring any three Pokemon I want. I don't have to worry about any particular Pokemon combination not working, because they, like, if I had them all 52, I couldn't bring three of them with me, because that would be 156. I could, for example, have, like, four of them be level 52 and then 251, and that would give me a few different combinations I could make work, but if I wanted to bring three of the Pokemon that were 52s, it wouldn't work. So the combination we have now is, like, the best we can possibly get while still being able to bring any combination of three we want. So it could be better, but it's fine. But all right, we did it. Three battles down already. Take that, Chester. All right, guys, let's go get into the final battle right here. Wah-ha-ha, I don't care about winning or losing. I guess not. So we're going to go for the Fog Badge. I think that we're just going to go ahead and stick to the formula, guys. We'll wrap it up after four. I know this is going to be a bit of a short episode, but... It'll let me actually get ahead a little bit on recording, so I don't have to have all those missed days like I did with Pokemon Crystal, so that's definitely a positive. Mutter, Pokemon, and Entropy? Huh? Don't disturb me! Dude, we're going to go into a battle here! This guy's got a much more interesting team. A few electric types. He's got, technically a poison type with Haunter and with, Ekans there, and then Porygon just the oddball. But notice, Porygon and Electrode are both level 55, which means he can only bring one of those. He can't bring both of them. I think we're gonna start with Poo, because Poo's Earthquake will be good against almost everything here. And we'll bring Tuix for the poison types, just in case those pop up. And then I guess we'll also bring... I don't know, man. We'll just bring Nox for some reason. Let's go! Yeah, I think Poo will probably be able to just Earthquake everything. Maybe the Porygon will give him a little bit of trouble, but honestly, if he sends out Porygon, I'll probably just go for a return and wreck him that way. So right here, he is going to send out Flaffy. I'm pretty sure Flaffy will die from one shot from Earthquake, so this should be not too bad. So yeah, we'll go for Earthquake right here. Do we go first? We do! Now, Poo is actually a fairly slow Pokemon, but I guess Flaffy is just even slower. So there we go, super effective. There is no way they're surviving that, no. Super effective, of course. Earthquake, a very powerful attack, and Poo is a great physical attacker. There's just no way they're gonna survive from that crud. So alright, we've got two more Pokemon to go. The only thing that might even kinda be scary is Porygon. And no, he goes for Electrode, alright. Now, Electrode might have Explosion. That could probably kill me. He's also gonna be faster than me, because Electrode is extremely fast. Oh, he goes for Screech of all things. That is fine. That's just going to lower my defense, which I don't really care about. Now, if he went for, like, a Thunder Wave, I could have potentially got very unlucky and started getting paralyzed a lot and not been able to do anything. But Screech, yeah. I mean, he's not even going to have a chance to attack me. Screech lowers my physical defense. Whoa, he actually survived, though. I guess because he's level 55 there. Let's just go for another one. Okay, maybe he will have a chance to attack me, but then he goes for Sonic Boom, which does 20 damage guaranteed. Now, if he did Screech and then went for, like, Self-Destruct, that might have killed me, but Screech into Sonic Boom is a really stupid move, and all of his electric attacks would be special attacks, so Screech wouldn't even matter with those ones. So I don't know what's going on here. I guess it's because it's still the Pokeball Cup, or it's the Pokeball division of the Poke Cup, so it's still pretty easy. The AI is not going to be the smartest all the time. So the final Pokemon cannot be Porygon, which means I don't really care what it is. It's going to be Haunter, which is totally fine, because Haunter is part poison. He will be weak to this crud, and look how giant Haunter is, dude. And he's going to go for Curse. That does half of his HP to himself, but it does a lot of damage to me. It's kind of like getting poisoned, but even more dangerous. The problem for him is he's going to be dead, so I'm not even going to take any damage from that poison. Down goes Haunter, and that is going to be a very easy way to wrap up this cup right here. All right, that is the end of battle. Take that, super nerd Clifford. Look at the face on Ursaring, man. I guess Nox and Tuix have funny faces as well, but definitely Ursaring. So Pokemon Trainer Psycho, me, we win. My logic wasn't faulty. There must still be a missing element. All right, dude. Well, that's going to be the Fog Badge. Like I said, guys, we're going to stick to the formula and wrap it up here. So I know it's a bit short, but we will come back next time and do the final four battles. And I'll also throw in something extra just to make it so it's not just a total swamp next time as well. So thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you then. Take care.